Another thing that many people, or some people, put out there is that oxygen-based products, these are products that are usually have oxygen bound with magnesium or some other mineral. Magnesium is really one of the most common ones, that this has an anti-candida effect. Given again that the intestinal tract is anaerobic, you have to consider that if I put oxygen in there, I have 100 trillion microorganisms that are anaerobic microorganisms. So that's all the bacteria, good, bad, whatever. The protozoa, the mold, the fungus, the yeast, they're all living in an anaerobic environment. If I add oxygen to them, I disrupt the entire environment. So while these products may release very, very, very extremely trace amounts of oxygen, the likelihood that that would specifically target one organism in there and not the others is very remote. So if you're taking something that could actually induce oxygen into the intestinal tract, you would be destroying the bacteria also. The things that you wouldn't destroy are candida. And candida is what we call a facultative anaerobe. When we look at microorganisms, they're usually obligate, which means they have to be in a certain environment, or they're facultative, which means they can adapt to the environment. And this is the case with candida. It's facultative, which means it can live in an oxygen environment, or it can live in an oxygen-deprived environment. In the gut, it lives in an oxygen-deprived environment. When it enters your bloodstream, it lives in an oxygen-rich environment. And that's where we have systemic fungal infections that spread through the body. You can have candida infections of the skin, oral candidiasis or thrush, that's exposed to a very oxygen-rich environment. So introducing an oxygen-based substance into the intestinal tract would have no effect against candida, but you would pretty much guarantee that you would be destroying some of the anaerobic organisms which don't have this ability to shift from oxygen to oxygen-deprived environments. And so you would actually select for the organisms which are very resistant in this way. So that would be E. coli, which is commonly associated with many many types of illnesses that people get from eating food contaminated with E. coli, systemic fungal candida, etc. If you try to starve candida out of the body, you won't do that. That will actually cause a conversion. In essence, if you take away all its food, candida goes shopping. It spreads through the body, it looks for nutrients, it finds them through the cells, the tissues, it creates abscesses, inflammation, destroys tissues, it'll destroy cells to get protein, destroy cells to get fat, destroy cells to get iron. It'll leach iron from red blood cells. So you can't starve it, but on the other hand, we don't really want to promote excessive or rapid growth.